We are beginning tonight with a disturbing discovery in Marina. The body of an autistic man who had been missing for more than a week was found on a Marina beach at about 8 o'clock this morning.
30-year-old Erik Lippmann was found washed ashore just north of Marina State Beach near Lapis Road. It is not clear how he died, and at this point, investigators say they aren't ruling out anything.
We have live team coverage on the tragedy. We begin with Action News reporter Felix Cortez, who reports tonight live from Marina.
Well, Dan, Aaron, the body of Erik Lippmann was found behind this CEMEX plant here in Marina, bringing a tragic end to the week-long search for the autistic man.
Sheriff's deputies got the call just before 8 Thursday morning. An employee at this CEMEX plant off Lapis Road discovered a body on the beach.
Our deputies responded and found a unclothed a body deceased on the beach that apparently washed ashore. So all we knew at the time was he was a white male, approximately in his late 20s, early 30s.
No clothing was found and no identification, but investigators knew right away who the person might be.
Well, of course, we were aware of the missing autistic gentleman from Santa Cruz, and we immediately thought that this could be him. We ultimately were able to identify him as such through fingerprints when here at the office.
Investigators identified the person as 30-year-old Erik Lippmann, an autistic man who was reported missing more than a week ago in Santa Cruz. Investigators say he did have a head injury, but nothing that appeared to be fatal. And at this time, foul play isn't suspected.
The obvious speculation could be that, for whatever reason, maybe he decided to go swimming.
An exact cause of death won't be known until an autopsy is completed, and that's not expected to be done until tomorrow. Dan, Aaron.
All right, Felix, thank you.
Action News reporter Phil Gomez spent the day with Lippmann's family, and he continues our team coverage live from Santa Cruz tonight.
Well, Aaron, it's been more than a week since Erik Lippmann walked away from his Seabright Avenue home. Today, the search ended along with the hope that Erik would be found alive. Family and volunteers met this morning to plan a massive search for Erik Lippmann Saturday when police received word that a body had washed up near Marina State Beach. His mother still had hope.
I'm trying to hold it together. I am hopeful that it's not him. But I know that it could be him, but I know he's with God. And that helps me.
But by early afternoon, the Monterey County coroner confirmed what everybody feared. A thumbprint match confirmed it was Erik.
I think I speak for the entire countywide law enforcement when I say this is not the outcome we had hoped for. We'd put a lot of resources into it, and our hearts really do go out to the family today.
Those resources included volunteer search parties scouring parks and open spaces, and a Facebook page that received 5,000 hits. But despite those efforts, it still ended tragically.
We're holding up the best we can. We want to make his death into the most positive situation that we can. We want to basically make missing person awareness in this community a high, high, high priority and get a task force together.
A candlelight vigil is planned for Erik this Saturday night around 6 o'clock at Seabright State Beach. Family members are asking that you check the missing person Facebook page for details.
All right. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Phil.
This is the third time in the past month that a search for a missing person has ended tragically in Santa Cruz County.
And those involved in search and rescue would like to prepare a manual so people can follow a procedure on what's the best action to take should a missing person's case come up.